Hello everyone, I am going to teach chapter electricity and the topics I am going to cover in this session are electricity and different sources of electricity, electric charge, conductors and insulators, electric current and as follows. So electricity, we know many electrical appliances in our home run on electricity. And we can define electricity as the presence and flow of electric charge or electrons in one direction. In my next slide, I will discuss electric charge in details. Electricity can also be defined as a form of energy that can be carried by wires and is used for heating, lighting, and to provide power for machine. So next question that comes in our mind is, what are the different sources of electricity? See, we can generate electricity with coal, wind, solar, nuclear energy, etc. In the given slide, we can see when circuit is closed, the electrons start moving. So this electron is called electric charge. And this is responsible for the glowing of bulb. So let us discuss electric charge in details. In the animation given alongside, we can see when a plastic rod is rubbed with silk cloth, then plastic rod becomes charged and it starts attracting small pieces of paper. This is how we can create electric charge. So we can say the basic fundamental unit of electricity is electric charge. These are of two types, positive charge and negative charge. The body which loses electron becomes positively charged and the one which gains electron becomes negatively charged. The SI unit of electric charge is coulomb. There are some properties of electric charge like same charges repel and opposite charges attract. Charges are conserved, meaning if one body loses some electron, then other body gains equal number of electrons so that the total sum of the charges remains constant. Charges are quantized, meaning we can calculate the total electron or total charge transferred from one body to another. Next we have insulators and conductors. We know this, insulators are those substances that have the property to obstruct the flow of electricity, that they do not allow electric charge to flow through them. We have example, rubber, plastic, etc. And conductors. Conductors are those substances that have the property to conduct electricity through them. They allow electric charge to flow through them easily. Example, copper, aluminium. Okay, next we have electric current. So electric current is defined as the flow of charge per unit time. We can also define it as the rate of flow of electric charge and the intensity of which we usually measured in ampere. In the slide given below, you can see how electrons are moving from one end to the other end across the conductor. We will discuss this in detail in the next slide. Ammeter. Ammeter is a device which is used for measuring the electric current that flows through the given circuit. There are some important points to be noted here that an ammeter should have a very low resistance so that it may not change the value of current flowing in the circuit. And it is always connected in series in a circuit. Next we have numerical based on electric current. A current of 0.5 ampere is drawn by a filament of an electric bulb for 10 minutes. Find the amount of electric charge that flows through the circuit. So we are given current of 0.5 ampere that flows through the circuit for time 10 minutes. If we convert this time into seconds, we have 600 seconds. So from the relation I equals to Q by T or Q equals to IT, on multiplying current and time, we can calculate the total charge flow through the circuit. Next, we have electric potential difference. It is important to know how electrons moves across the conductor. What makes the electric charge to flow in a conductor? Charges do not flow in a copper wire by themselves. For flow of charges in a conducting metallic wire, the electrons move only if there is a difference of electric pressure called the potential difference along the conductor. And this difference is created by a cell or a battery. The energy provided by the battery is equal to the work done on the charge. Thus, electric potential difference can be defined as the amount of work done on given charge. Mathematically, we can write it as V equals to W by Q. That is, electric potential difference between two points is given by work done per unit charge. Next, we have voltmeter. So voltmeter is an instrument used for measuring electric potential difference between two points in an electric circuit. There are some important points to be noted here. Voltmeter has a high resistance so that it takes negligible current, because the primary function of voltmeter is to measure the voltage, to measure the potential difference between two points and not the electric current. And it is always connected in parallel in a circuit. Next, we have numerical based on electric potential difference. How much work is done in moving a charge of 2 coulomb across two points having a potential difference of 12 volt? So we are given amount of charge that flows through the circuit is 2 coulomb through a potential difference of 12 volt. From the relation V equals to W by Q, we can calculate the total work done as W equals to V into Q. On multiplying, we get the total work done of 24 joule. So electric circuit is defined as the closed path for transmitting electric current. It consists of various electrical components. So in the given circuit, we can see the following electric circuit consists of a battery whose function is to provide energy so that electric charge can move in a conducting wire. It consists of a switch. The function of switch is to make or break the circuit. If switch is closed, then bulb starts glowing. If switch is open, then bulb does not glow. Next slide shows the different electrical components and their symbols. So we have electric cell. An electric cell is represented by two vertical lines. One is bigger. The bigger one is act as positive terminal and the smaller one is for negative terminal. Second, we have battery. Battery is combination of different cells. If we combine cells in series, we call it battery. We have plug key open, plug key closed, a wire joint, wires crossing without joining, a symbol for electric bulb, a resistor of resistance R, variable resistance or rheostat, ammeter, voltmeter. Okay, next we have Ohm's law. See, Ohm's law gives the relation between electric potential difference and the current flowing through the circuit. According to Ohm's law, the potential difference V across the ends of a given metallic wire in an electric circuit is directly proportional to the current flowing through it, provided its temperature remains the same. Meaning, the current that flows through a circuit is proportional to electric potential difference, or vice versa. The figure shows the circuit which is used for studying the Ohm's law. We will discuss this in next slide. Mathematically, we can represent Ohm's law as V proportional to I. And when we remove proportionality sign, we multiply it with some constant. The constant here we are using is R. So the mathematical expression for Ohm's law is V equals to RI. We can also represent Ohm's law as I equals to V by R. Therefore, the two points can be noted here. First, the current is directly proportional to potential difference, and the current is inversely proportional to resistance of the conductor. Next, we have resistance. Resistance can be defined as the obstruction to the flow of charge. See, when an electron moves along the conductor, it comes in contact with the fixed atom which is present within the conducting material, due to which it undergoes collision, and the path and the motion of electrons becomes difficult. This property of the material is called resistance. The resistance of an object depends in larger parts on the material it is made up of. For example, for insulators like rubber, rubber has high resistance and low conductivity. So electrons cannot move through insulators. Whereas objects made of electric conductor like metals such as aluminium, copper has low resistance and have high conductivity. This is the reason copper and aluminium wire are used in household electric wiring. So this property of material dependence is called resistivity. We'll discuss resistivity in the next slide. The SI unit of resistance is ohm. Now we have numericals based on Ohm's law. A part, how much current will an electric bulb draw from a 220 volt source if the resistance of the bulb filament is 1200 ohm? So in A part, we are given potential difference of 220 volt, resistance 1200 ohm. On applying Ohm's law, we can calculate the value of current as 0.18 ampere. Similarly, we can try B part. Next question we have, the potential difference between the terminals of an electric heater is 60 volt when it draws a current of 4 ampere from the source. What current will the electric heater draw if the potential difference is increased to 120 volt? So this question consists of two parts. First, we need to calculate the resistance, and then to find electric current. We are given potential difference of 60 volt and a current of 4 ampere. On applying Ohm's law, first we calculate the resistance, which is coming to 15 ohm. Since in the second part, we increases the voltage from 60 volt to 120 volt. So there will be no change in the resistance. So we use the same resistance as in the first part. And again, applying Ohm's law, we can calculate the current, which is coming out to be 8 ampere. Now I am assigning you this worksheet, which is based on today's lecture. And you are supposed to do this worksheet on A4 size sheets very neatly. I will also send this worksheet on WhatsApp group. In my next lecture, I will start with the topic factors affecting resistance. See you in next lecture. Thank you.